the Lord, beloved. Welcome to another exciting week on the Voice of Resurrection devotional. The Lord has ministered to us powerfully the last 2 weeks. We've considered the different soils of our heart, where the Word of God is sown and the results that emanated from those situations. This week, we want to study a heart filled with thorns. Yes, a heart filled with thorns. Before I give you the understanding or the explanation, the question is your heart thorny? What is that? First of all, let's get to the text in Mark chapter 4, verse 7, on what we call the parable of the sower. The Bible says, "And some fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no fruit." Then we go to verse 18, where the same text gives us the explanation. "And these are they which are sown among thorns, such as hear the word, and the cares of this world, and the deceitfulness of riches, and the lusts of other things entering in, choke the word, and it becometh unfruitful." Amen. We will go to the book of Matthew later to see the other dimensions of the same mystery. But beloved, Jesus says that when the word of God is sown in a heart full of thorns, the things that constitute thorns choke the word. The book of Matthew says, when we read it, you will see it. It says, "And the man became unfruitful." Wow. In other words, there is no way you and I can bear fruit with a thorny heart. No, it's not possible. And Jesus says that a thorny heart is a heart full of cares, a heart full of lust, a heart full of different stresses that enter in. Oh, there's so many mysteries in this text. He said they enter in. The Holy Spirit showed me a few years ago that so long as what you're going through has not entered your heart and it stays on the outside of you, you have the power to master it. You have the power over it. You can take authority over it. You can resist it. You can cast it down, and it will obey you. But the moment you allow that hurt, that pain, that situation, that circumstance, that need to infiltrate your heart, to get in your spirit, when it enters in, it chokes the word, and you become unfruitful. So our fight is to make sure that whatever we are hurt by, whatever we are distressed by, whatever it is we are dealing with, that we keep it out of our spirit. And if it enters in, push it out very quickly. Get rid of it. Don't allow it to settle, because you cannot carry it and have a fruitful day. You cannot carry it and have a prosperous life. You must get rid of it. Hallelujah. I ask you again, beloved, do you have thorns growing in your heart? The text says, "And the thorns grew up." Some of us have lived a life of drama for so long. We're always stressed out about everything. We always are overcharged with cares, that these things have grown in intensity, grown in strength, grown in power, until that's the way we live. But beloved, God has sent me this morning to give you understanding, to bring deliverance to you in the name of the Lord, by revelation, so that you yourself can get rid of Satan, to get rid of these demons, to learn to release cares to the Lord, as we will find out as we go through this week. You would discover, beloved, nothing pleases the Lord as when we release the cares to Him. We have so much to learn, and I pray that you will leave home today and go to work without the cares of this world, that you will go to work without the stresses of the circumstances you're dealing with. Has the light been turned off? I said, well, how could you hear me? Maybe you're watching on someone else's computer. Maybe you are somewhere else, at the library or whatever. Is the light turned off? Are the bills unpaid? Are they coming to repossess the car? Beloved, your worry and your stress is not an answer. It's not a solution. May God help you develop the strength to get rid of the thorns, and you will walk in total victory in Jesus' name. Amen. I will see you tomorrow. We love you. We're praying for you. Bye-bye. The Lord is waiting on you. Yes, He is. Yes, He is.